Hey everybody, this is Jake from Mito. I'm really excited to be sharing this tool with you all today. Mito is a spreadsheet front-end for Python. What that means is that you can call a spreadsheet-like interface into your notebook, and every edit you make in that interface is going to create the equivalent Python for you, the equivalent pandas for you. It's a really powerful tool. Lots of our users are using it to complete their analyses more quickly, have a more visual aspect to their data, and you know, really just have a more enjoyable time doing their analysis for Python. And I'll show you exactly what that looks like. So the first thing we're gonna do is import the MITRE sheet package, and then we'll call mitresheet.sheet. To get to this point, we need to install the MITRE package first. So all you have to do is go to our install instructions on our website and follow them here. We'll also link this in the description of the video, of course. I wanna run the cell. This mitresheet.sheet call will call our blank spreadsheet here. And now we can get data into the tool. So we can either pass in a data frame directly as an argument. This would be if you're working with data frames already in your cells above and you want to pass this in, super easy to do. You can call in a MITRE sheet at any point in your analysis. Or we can use the import button here. I'll click add file from current folder. That will go to the current folder that I'm looking at right here. Look what files I can use. I can select from any of my files. I'm going to use this one. I'm also going to add a second file. And we see both files, both CSVs, end up as different tabs, different data frames in this spreadsheet. Close this menu. We'll see here that the code we've automatically generated is turning the CSVs into data frames. So that's handled for you. You don't have to write any code yourself for that part. Now that we're in the tool, well, the first thing I want to do is I want to merge these data sets together. Both of them have this zip code column. I'll quickly click our merge modal. This will make a new data frame where the merge is going to happen. We set our merge keys, which is the columns we want to join on. We decide what sheets we want to merge. We only have two, so we're going to keep the default. And we can decide what columns from each sheet to keep in the merge. For this case, we want to keep all of them. So this is already defaulted to what we exactly what we want it to be. So I'll close this. Here's our merge data set on the zip code column. And below, you see we've generated the code for that merge. Decently complex code that might take you some time to write. Might have to go Google that syntax. In this case, no, it's just generated right for you. The next thing I want to do is I want to pivot on this. So I'm going to create my pivot table here. As my rows, I'm going to select state. And as my values, I'm going to select zip codes. And I want to see the count of how many zip codes I have for each state. So here's our chart. Here's our count. The count of zip codes for each state. We created a really simple pivot table. Again, that makes a new data frame. And below, we generate the code for that pivot table. Let's say I want to filter this pivot table. So I only want to look at the states that contain the letter A, for example. There we go. We get our subset of the data. I can close this. And again, we generate the code for that filter. Now I can graph this as well. So I'm going to click graph. As my x-axis, I'm going to put state. And as my y-axis, I'm going to put the amount of the codes. And here's our graph showing that data. I can close this. I can also do formulas inside the MITRE sheet to analyze and manipulate my data. So I'm going to add a column here. Let's just say I want to do something simple like concatenate these columns together to sort of make a state zip code code together. I'll use a concatenate function, select state, select zip code. And there we go. There's our concatenated function. And you see, for everything we're doing, we're generating the equivalent code below that you can carry forward and use in the rest of your analysis. There's lots more you can do in MITRE, but definitely don't have time to show you everything. I hope you enjoy the tool. I hope you try it out. If you need anything at all, please reach out. We're always eager to talk to our users and really build with them. So thanks so much.